Hello and welcome, Virgo. I am Pisces Intuition here with your weekly reading. All right, so Virgo, keep in mind this is a general reading, so take what resonates and leave the rest behind. Not all messages will be for you. Let's see. All right, so let's go ahead. Let's see what is coming out, what's going on, and what is it that you need to know for Virgo. All right. All right, so bottom of the deck, we do have that Two of Swords showing up. See, I don't know if that showed you very well. There you go. All right, so bottom of the deck, like I said, Two of Swords. It feels like you're being torn in two different directions, is what I keep getting here, Virgo. But we do have the Devil card. We have the Hermit card. So you are showing up here in your own reading. We have the Magician. We have Five of Swords. We have the Seven of Cups. So you could be dealing with a Capricorn. Hold on, that really caught my eye there. Okay, so Virgo, this is going to be a mess. This is not going to resonate for everybody, but it does feel like you guys are really kind of cutting ties with someone who you feel has just been kind of toxic, who has kind of almost been like a puppeteer. You see how the strings are? It just feels like you're kind of like cutting ties with this person, and it feels like you're really kind of just going on your own path. It's like you're trying to find yourself here with the Hermit. You're trying to find answers. For some of you, this is like an awakening, and it's like you know you needed to cut ties with this person from your past. And like I said, it just kind of feels like you're moving forward. This does not have to be a Capricorn. Like I said, I know this is a card of Capricorn, but this is more just showing me that this is you cutting ties with a toxic situation, person, relationship, but it's moving forward, okay? Virgo, it does feel like you're kind of doing your own thing right now. It feels like you're, single for some of you here, is what I keep getting. But it does look like you're going to be having some choices. It just feels like right now you're getting past a lot of hurt, a lot of mind games. It feels like a lot of you have kind of been misled. And it's like now you're having to figure out your truth or the answers for yourself. It's like you're trying to figure out where you want to go or where you're supposed to be. Like I said, this really kind of feels like the beginning stages of like an awakening process. For some of you, this is, finding yourself on a spiritual journey, really asking those deep questions, really going within, really doing some soul searching. But Virgo, I am seeing you though, like I said, with this Magician here, bringing about some kind of change, changing something, getting out of the toxicity, because we go from dark to, we see some kind of light in the sky here, and then we just go full on light. It's like, you're bringing some kind of balance in to your situation. It's like you're searching for those answers. Like I said, doing some soul searching here, it feels like you're trying to find your place or where you belong. For some of you, with the Seven of Cups, this is having, opportunities. This is having choices. This is having options. Yes, there's some confusion because, when we are presented with more than one option, it's not always easy to know which one is right for me. Which one is going to be the best for me, not just in the here and now, but, down the road in the future, what is going to be the best choice? And so that's what it really kind of feels like. You're really just kind of taking your time and figuring out, like I said, doing that soul searching, really trying to figure out what is the best option for you. What is the best choice for you? What is the best path for you? Because like I said, it just feels like a lot of you have really kind of done, or just kind of been like misled. Or it's like, I'm getting some trust issues here. It feels like because there was a toxic situation or a person involved. For some of you, this is cutting out your own toxicities. So maybe you're getting past some codependency. Maybe you're, like I said, it just feels like you're on a whole new path. And it feels like you're going through, like I said, the beginning stages of some kind of awakening. So yeah, but the magician, like I said, having those tools in front of you, knowing how to use them, knowing how to manifest a brand new beginning, a fresh new start, you know, making your choice and just going with it. It's really figuring things out and feeling comfortable in your own skin, feeling comfortable with who you are, which kind of feels to me like you haven't felt that way in a really long time. Like I said, especially for those of you who are cutting out toxic people, you know, we are in Mercury retrograde, so I mean, that could have something to do with it. But it just really kind of feels like you want to put the past in the past, or you want to put these people or this situation like in the past, and you just want to move forward. It's like you're looking for that light at the end of the tunnel. All right, let's go ahead and let's take a few more cards here. Yeah, like I said, for some of you, well, yeah, this has been a really tough decision to make. It feels like you're almost being pulled in two different ways. Because it feels like, you know, a part of you just wants to release and wants to let go, but it feels like you don't know how. Or if you're making the right decision. So like I said, this situation is really requiring some soul searching here. You know, it's like really getting out of your head, seeing things for what they really are. Because it does feel, like I said, somebody's kind of toxic here, playing some mind games or just misleading somebody. All right, this is a different deck of cards. I just want to get any additional messages for Virgo. Yep. All right. So bottom of the deck, we do have that Empress card. Beautiful, beautiful. So rebirthing a new beginning. Like I said, making some changes here, doing some soul searching. You know, coming out as a whole new you. So three of inspiration, it's taking the action to do so. Like I said, for a lot of you, it felt like you're being pulled in two different directions. Like, which way should I go? What choice should I make? Like, things like that. But a lot of you, it's about, you know, finally taking that action, making that choice, and moving forward. It's about learning lessons, putting the past in the past, learning from them, growing from them, you know, using them to your advantage, not trying to, you know, conceal them or hide from them. You know, or be ashamed of them or not deal with them. It's like actually healing from them, you know, and then moving forward. Like I said, really using it to help you grow, you know, and growing towards a brand new beginning, a brand new opportunity. Like I said, with this Ace of Materials, you know, absolutely amazing. This is, you know, planning something new. Like I said, a big door of, you know, opportunity opening up for you. So where something ends, you know, because it kind of just feels like there's a person or a situation here that is just, you know, again, toxicity, have to bring that up. But it just really kind of feels like it's holding you back. You know, it's really kind of just pulling you back. It's keeping you from progressing or moving forward to where you need to be. But yeah, it feels like you're doing some soul searching and you're finding yourself, you're finding your way, you're getting on your path. And it's like, you know, you're learning those lessons. Like I said, you're healing from things, you're using it to your advantage, and you're manifesting a whole new beginning. You're manifesting this Ace of Materials. So this could be, you know, the start of abundance to financial matters, to stability, you know, towards, you know, home, towards a relationship. Like I said, this could be so many different beginnings for you. So however this is resonating, like I said, you are manifesting that. You're bringing that into your reality here. All right, so let's go ahead and let's take some energy oracle cards. So bottom of the deck, we have door to personal healing and happiness. So beautiful, beautiful. Like I said, opening up that door of opportunity, manifesting that, using that healing to really help you grow and, you know, put you on the path that you need to be on. All right. Yeah, definitely going towards victory, going towards success, you know, closing out cycles and just moving towards, you know, a brighter future, moving towards your goals. Third chakra, this is talking about your solar plexus. For some of you, maybe, you know, you've been changing up your diet, or you've noticed some, you know, issues with, like, you know, digestion or things like that. So just keep that in mind, but definitely, you know, put in that chakra work. You know, do the meditations, like, you know, you will notice such a difference. I promise you, it is worth it. Okay. It's worth the time to do that for yourself, to take some self-care, self-love, you know, just take care of you, you know, a few minutes a day, just meditate, you know, get back into the right headspace. Like I said, it opens up wonders. Appreciation, definitely appreciating how far you've come. Definitely appreciating the little things around you, what it took to get you there. Because like I said, you are opening up new opportunities here. So, alrighty. Let's see. I think I'm going to do a moonology for you guys. Alright. So we have step out of your comfort zone. We have the end of a tough cycle approaches, beautiful, and then your commitment is being tested. So, you know, are you committed to yourself? Are you committed to actually healing? Are you committed to actually moving forward to a new beginning? You know, it's like spirit is kind of testing you. You're going through some tests right now. So, you know, just keep that in mind. But the end of a tough cycle is approaching. You know, you just may have to kind of come out of that comfort zone, you know, get out of that stagnant energy, because sometimes we get stuck there and we get too comfortable there. And then before you know it, it's like so much time has passed and we haven't taken any action. So don't get stuck there. Make sure you come out of your comfort zone every now and then. All right. I wasn't going to do this oracle card, but I think for some of you, you're going to want to know, and we just need to get some love messages. Do we have anything that Virgo needs to know? All right, so we have, I regret lying to you, and I'm afraid to contact you. All right, so yeah, so there we go. Some situations coming up from the past. Like I said, Mercury retrograde. We're going to be hearing, you know, from people from our past. That's just kind of a given there, so keep that in mind. It feels like this person could have lied to you in the past, maybe about their feelings or, you know, about other situations. Keep in mind, it's going to be different for everybody. But it does feel like there is some dishonesty within the connection. So they may, in fact, want to reach out. They may be thinking about it, but right now, fear is just kind of in control. So whether or not they actually do it, they need to get past their own fear in order to reach that, you know, putting, you know, I was getting something else for that, but it didn't come through. But yeah, but definitely, like I said, getting past their fear in order to, you know, open up the connection of communication again. So, all right, because maybe it's, you know, they don't know how you're going to react. Maybe it's, you know, if they did lie to you, there was, like I said, some mistrust, you know, some dishonesty there. It's like they don't know how you're going to take it or if you even want to talk to them. And so, like I said, that has a lot to do with the whole fear of them contacting you. So, all right, well, Virgo, I do hope this helps your situation or at least gives you some kind of clarity or insight. Thank you so very much for watching. I do appreciate it. So until next time, take care.